Hello, and thank you for joining me on Word of Inspiration. My name is Dr. Bertha Aye, and I bring you a program that is designed to encourage and motivate you in your daily walk and hopefully help you to fulfill God's purpose for your life. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I want you to rejoice and be glad in it. It brings me great joy to bring you this message, which I've entitled, You Are the Salt of the Earth. My text is taken from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 13, where Jesus says, You are the salt of the earth, but if the salt loses its savor, what shall men do with it? It shall be cast out, and men will trod under their foot with it. You are the salt of the earth. My hope is that by the end of this message, you will understand that no matter where you are and whatever role that you play in this life, you are making an impact with your life. You don't need to be a master chef like Anthony Bourdain, who recently passed away, to understand the value of salt. Try cooking some rice without salt. It doesn't taste very good. On the other hand, if you were to take an equal part of rice and an equal part of salt to cook, it would taste terrible. It means you don't need a whole lot of salt to bring out the taste of anything that you cook. Take the sweetest confectionery that you can think of, cakes, muffins, whatever. They all need just a touch of salt to even bring out the taste of the sugar. In the same way, you are the salt of the earth. You bring out the flavor of life. Your life has value. You make a difference no matter where you are and whatever role you are playing in this life. Jesus likens the impact that you make in society to the salt, that the role that salt plays. Sometimes people lose the salt. How does that happen? In Jesus' time, research has it that salt that was used at that time was derived from salty marshes so that over time the salt could leach out and you would be left with this residue that has no value and therefore it was trodden over. As you hold on to your integrity, your purity, your moral values, you are the salt of the earth. You are making a difference. Sometimes due to pressures of this life, you can allow yourself to leak out those values and you lose whatever impact you're making in this life. Today, I came to encourage you to hold on to that which is good. Salt can also be a preservative. You would notice that because it has such a high or smaller content, if you put it on anything, fish, vegetables, some types of fish in certain parts of Africa can be preserved for years just by adding the salt. How does it do that? When salt gets around bacteria, because the salt content outside of the bacterial cell wall is so high, they lose any fluid in them, the bacterial cell wall ruptures and the bacteria dies. In so doing, salt can preserve food for many, many years. In the same way, you being salt, you're like a moral disinfectant. Wherever you go, your presence can cause things to be preserved. You need to keep those values. Don't ever lose them. Sometimes people think their lives don't have value. And so they decide, what am I to people? I can't talk about salt without remembering the events that happened recently with Chef Anthony Bourdain. I'm sure at some point in his life, he thought, you know what, I have no value. Maybe I should just end my life. But when he passed away, he's left a hole in so many hearts. So many hearts. He made such a big difference in many people's lives, young and old, all over the world. I bet he didn't know that. I wish every day people would have sent him a message and said, we love you, we care about you, we love what you're doing. I bet he never got that kind of feedback. Today, if you have somebody in your life who is like the salt, making an impact in your life in one small way or the other, send them a message. Let them know, hey, you mean a lot to me. You're like salt in my life. In the same way, just know, even if you don't get any feedback, that you make a big difference in so many people's lives on a daily basis. As you go through life, let the Holy Spirit be the ultimate enhancer. As you go around, sprinkle some love, sprinkle some joy, sprinkle some kindness, a little bit of forgiveness, a little bit of patience, some gentleness maybe, some faith, some goodness in somebody's life, and be the salt of this earth. God richly bless you. Please join me next time. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he cause his countenance to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May he lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace. Please say these words after me. I am the salt of the earth. My life has value, no matter how small of a part I play. Today, I'm the head and not the tail. I'm more than a conqueror. The Holy Spirit allows me to be a great enhancer. I shall not die, but I will live to fulfill God's plan and God's purpose for my life. I've been programmed to succeed, and I will not fail. Please join me next time. This has been Dr. Bertha Aye with Word of Inspiration. God richly bless you.